And now we will learn how to apply payments to vendors' bills and deposits to customers' invoices using the Bank Feed Center. Applying checks and payments to vendors' bills, well, that's a breeze. Applying the payment is the same as paying from the usual pay bills window. The results can be seen on the unpaid bills report. For example, let's apply the $75 check from May 25th, 2017 to the two oldest bills from FedEx. Well, that should be very simple. Here we are in the review list. Now, here we are at the $75 check on May 25th. This is the only $75 check we have for the date May 25th. So we're talking about this one. Now, all we have to do is go to the right of the same row that this check is on and click Select Bills to Mark as Paid. Now, once we're in this window, we simply choose the vendor that has unpaid bills with us. And when we click FedEx, the three unpaid bills for FedEx come up. Now, QuickBooks remembers that this was a $75 payment that we're applying. Very simple, if it's to the two oldest ones, all we have to do is click the check mark on the oldest one and click, and you see $25 has been applied and $50 is waiting to be applied. When we click the check mark here, there's the other $50. We applied the whole thing. Now, before I click Add to QuickBooks, I want to mention something important. You must apply all of the payment. You cannot generate a credit from the bank feeds window. So if you can't apply the entire $75 check, then you would have to go to the regular pay bills window to generate a credit with that vendor. Let me show you what I mean. If we uncheck this, well, we're applying a $75 payment and we're only applying $25 now. If I click Add to QuickBooks, we're going to get an error message. The total amount does not match the downloaded transaction amount! Exclamation point. If you want to do it that way, you have to use the regular pay bills window. So let's place the check mark here and apply the entire amount of the check to all or many of the unpaid bills for this vendor. When we click Add to QuickBooks, now it lets us do that. Now, of course, I frown upon rule creation. QuickBooks is suggesting that we take anything that happened to be in the description field at this moment and make a rule that it goes to FedEx. I don't want to do that. Let's just apply the payment and move on. So we click OK, and now if we open the unpaid bills report, we can see for FedEx, those two bills are gone. And they're gone because they're not unpaid anymore. We applied that check. Now, applying deposits to customers' invoices is almost the exact same thing as what we just did with vendors. Applying the payment is the same as paying from the usual receive payment window. And the results can be seen on the open invoice report. And if you're advanced in QuickBooks, you can look at the invoice history and you can see it looks the same. For example, let's apply the $60 received on May 8th to invoice number 2 from Joe. And then we'll check the open invoice report when we're done. So, here we are. We go here to the Bank Feed Center, and I think we said it was May 8th. All right, so May 8th is down here. Now you'll see once we apply it, it will disappear from the review list. So look closely that the one above is the 9th and the one below is the 2nd. Those will still be there and the May 8th will be gone after we apply it to the invoices. So on the same row as May 8th, we click Add More Details, and now you can see we have all the open invoices from the customers. And we want to apply it to the invoice for Joe for July 11th. It was invoice number 2. So we'll click the check mark here. Now, the problem is that when you click the check mark, it assumes you're paying the whole amount. You then have to come to this part of the window and overtype it with only the amount you're applying. In this case, the most we can apply is the amount of the deposit, $60. So again, click the check mark for which one it is and then come down here to clarify the money amount by overtyping in the amount field the amount you need. Push the tab key to seal the deal. And then when you click Add to QuickBooks, you might get this message, but don't worry. Now I promise I'm going to circle back to this message, which you don't even have to worry about, and I'm going to add 3 minutes to this video to explain this message. But except for this message, we're done. Click the check mark here, change the money amount down here, and click OK. Okay, of course, it always suggests a rule. I don't want it to follow the rule, so I'm going to shut that. Now look, when we come back here, we still see May 9th. We still see May 2nd, but we don't see May 8th because that one was added to QuickBooks. And I can check that by clicking here. Okay, here, where's the May 8th? If you come up to the section of May, there's the May 8th deposit for $60 added from the QuickBooks Center, the Bank Feed Center. And to check to be sure which invoice it was applied to, I can click Open Invoice, and you can see, instead of saying $660 here, for the July 11th invoice number 2, it only says $600. That's because $60 deposit was applied. I can open up this invoice and I can click reports and I can click transaction history, and you can see that it was $660 and that we applied $60 to the May 8th payment of $60, and that's why it brought the balance down to $600. Now folks, the video is technically over, and if you're able to repeat my actions and apply the deposits to the invoices, then you should just do it. But some students are going to want to know more about that message we got when we clicked, you know, to finally save the transaction and apply the deposit. Well, with customer deposits, QuickBooks does two steps in one. First, it records the deposit, it records the payment from the customer into undeposited funds. Then it immediately records a deposit from the undeposited funds into the bank account, the one you are reviewing at that moment. The way to understand this is to look at the journal. I have set up my journal so that it shows every transaction in the order in which it was entered into the computer, and I also have it in reverse order so that the most recent transactions are right on the top, and you'll see two transactions that literally happened at the same time. Let me show you. Here's my transaction journal, and you can see the most recent ones are on the top because I'm recording everything today on July 13th. Then it goes down to July 12th and so on. And you can see the last two entries were what we just did a moment ago. We just recorded a $60 deposit and we applied it to the invoices. Now, this column shows the date and time that it was entered. And you can see the second to last transaction that was just entered was the payment. QuickBooks does this and puts it into undeposited funds so that it's able to apply the payment to the proper invoice. If we double click, this is what it looks like. And it put it against this invoice and it put it towards undeposited funds. Now notice that happened at 4:53 p.m. and 15 seconds. And then literally 1 second later, 4:53 and 16 seconds, it made this deposit where it physically deposited or recorded it as a deposit from that particular payment. So these two basically happened at the same time when we clicked record. It went into undeposited funds, then it went from undeposited funds to the bank account in the blink of an eye. And that's the way it does it. You can prevent this by changing the default payment account in the preferences window. And again, we're getting a little off topic, but if you did this, edit, preferences, and went to payments, company preference, You could remove the check mark from undeposited funds here. Then when you click OK, now if you do the very same thing, you won't get two transactions and you won't get that message. It will go directly into the bank account. And to be honest, these last 3 minutes of this video probably won't make any difference.